Hi, my name is Silvir, and thank you all for joining our webinar today. Today, we will go over the transseptal puncture and its features and functionalities. For those who are new to Mantis and simulation in general, Mantis has been around for over 20 years. We are the only company that focuses on endovascular simulation, and we are a global company with offices all around the world. We develop solutions for health systems and also for the top medical devices around the world. So I will go ahead and start this webinar. As you can see, transseptal puncture, we have three cases today. We offer normal fossa, stiff fossa, and soft fossa. So why only three procedures? Well, these are the most common procedures that you would see in life, in real life. So we could build more, but I think these should be enough for now. So we'll go ahead and start our first case. And if we have enough time, we will go through a soft fossa just to give you a difference between the normal one and soft. As this is starting, I'll just go over a couple key benefits so that. So what can we offer from transseptal puncture? So you can learn the step-by-step of the transseptal puncture. We also have advanced imaging, ICE and TE. We can practice simulation in safe environment, and we can also try to take training away from real life into low risk environment. Back to our simulation. If you look on a scenario page, this is it talks a little bit about our patient today and procedure tab. So we have this is where we control the simulation a little bit. We have our proctor. In there, you can visualize the fossa valles. If you're not familiar with the procedure, if you look at the fluoro screen, I can highlight that if I need to. So if I click on fossa valles, it will kind of give me a cheat sheet where the fossa valles is. These are the echo controls, and we'll get into it once we get to the echo part and the ICE part. So I'll go ahead and insert our wire. And again, all of these clinical devices that we use on the simulator are real-life wires and catheters, so devices that you actually do use in real life. So I'll go ahead and insert our wire, and this is obviously a femoral approach. So we will see the wire come out of the introducer any moment now. So here's our wire. I have a full ability to rotate the wire, and it behaves pretty much one-to-one. So as I advance or pull back, I'll get the appropriate visualization on my forearm. So we'll go ahead and just push the wire over a little bit. And as you can see on the floral, we'll give you the PE probe. So you can see the where this. There's also some catheters highlighted as well. Those catheters are CS catheter, piece, and pigtail. And these can be enabled or disabled if need to be. If you're just using a pigtail to show your landmark, then you can just highlight the pigtail and take away that CS and the piece catheter. Kind of like this. Going into our echo. This is where we have the echo probe. And with this simulation today, echo probe is controlled by these buttons. So if I need to move the probe up and down, I'll just click this and it will do it for me. Also, we will see the change on the actual echo field. So whatever I do here, I will get some outcome on the echo window. So these are not still images. These are actual images that are taken from the probe. We also have some TE preset views. So if you are not familiar or you don't have the skills to move the probe, we also have some preset views where you can just click on it. For example, this is a bicable view and it will show you what the probe is looking at and also gives you appropriate picture here as well. And same thing for all the other views. Also, we have ICE capabilities, and as you can see, once I switch to ICE, the catheter, the TE probe will go away and it kind of gives you the ICE catheter. And the same thing with the ICE catheter, you control it by these buttons. You can rotate it, move it around. And also we have the piece of view, so you can just click on it and the picture will change on your ICE view. And it will also give you kind of like an example of what is it that you're looking at. And this is really great to use to teach different views and what you see as you're moving around these echo catheters. I'm just going to go ahead and pick my view that I like for these kind of procedures. I think this is a great one. This will highlight, as you can see my wire here, and it will kind of highlight the fossa nicely. And so I can see all of my drops as I go down into the fossa. So at this point, I will go ahead and use my Concepto sheet and the dilator. And again, I am using the real tools on the other end. So I do have my dilator here with the sheet loaded on it, put it together. And as I'm putting this over the wire, you can see on my fluoro screen, there's a sheet orientation and there's also a needle orientation. So what that means, this is something that you do not have in real life. And we kind of give you this so you can actually see where the sheet is and the editor, where they're pointing to. For example, if you have a sheet and dilator pointing in one direction, and you have a needle pointing in a different direction, then whatever you're looking at the fluoroscope screen would not be in the right spot. And this will also happen if you don't pay attention, so I must have. And all too fast, so. Well, let's reset this. I'm going to just pull back a little bit, push this up. And sorry about my struggles. Sometimes this will happen if I'm not too careful. So we have our wire in place. I have my sheet and dilator. And as you can see, now I'm pointing at 3 o'clock where we should be pointing. You might have seen a pop-up screen show up. And this is something that we have implemented. If you do, if something happens during the case that you should be aware of, you will get a pop-up screen. And in this case, it was pointing towards the X-ray. So it says that I'm 5 minutes on X-ray and that I should minimize it. I'm moving forward. Our simulator has a radiation safety tab or feature. What that does, it will estimate how much X-ray exposure you're exposing patient, the operator, and the team around you. So the simulator does keep track on that, and it will remind you if you are heavy on your X-ray. Also, one of the features are medications, and these can be used throughout the procedure. If you are putting in a needle, you should maybe flush it with heparin before inserting. If you don't do that, the system will, the simulator will remind you that you didn't flush with heparin and kind of ask you to do so. Okay, going back to transseptal puncture, we have our sheath and dilator in place. On my ice field, I can see kind of my sheath a little bit here. If I take out my wire and start slowly moving down, I will also see my dilator on there as well. So this is what it looks like on the ice cap. And now I will show you what this looks like on the PE. So quickly switch to PE. And this is a little bit different. As you can see, my dilator and sheath are not in the field of view yet. So that's why there's nothing here. But so this is the, I can highlight what the TE probe is looking at. So again, this is not in the field of view yet. So if I pull it back a little bit, it's just slowly creep up on us. And yeah, there it is. So this is my, I believe this is my battery. Yeah, it is. And again, same thing with Echo. There's just a couple different views that are preset. And we can use these buttons to tweak it. Or even find one that's not labeled on our go-to views at this point. So this is the one that I like the most, the SVC view. And as I was pushing back, maybe I just did the first jump already, but you should be able to see the jet second one when you go into the fossa. I'll go ahead and turn this off. Okay. We also have a 3D view. This is kind of like a 3D overlay. What I like about this is that if you would like to teach anatomy, you can use this 3D view, and as you move your table around and the C-arm, it will spin around and it will give you kind of like a 3D image of it. Maybe it is a little hard to see since there's a lot of going on, but it's still a great tool to show you what this anatomy looks like. So this is just a 3D overlay, and then this is kind of like a full 3D with our pigtail in place. The pigtail is not just there for landmark. I can actually shoot contrast through it. Mm-hmm. And then I can also I can flush ceiling if I need to flush my needle. If I need continuous flushing, we can do that. And then I also have we can check the ACPs. The presets are, these are just the presets for different floral view. On my end here in front of me, I do have a joystick or a control box. So what I can do is I can move the table around, and I can also move the C-arm if I need to. And our simulator does track the total amount of time we use, floral time. Contrast, if you're making in and making out, keep track of that. And it also will show us the angles that we are in. For example, this one is at the LA of 26 and bottle 60. And this little box, it just, this is just the radiation safety numbers that we have here. So I'll go ahead and click on our needle. Even though we use real clinical devices in our simulators, we do have to tell our systems what shapes we use. And this is the process that I'm doing now. So we have, in this case, we have three different needles. One is just a regular needle. Second is the, has a little bit of a bigger angle or shape, and then this one is a little bit more steeper. So this is just selecting what angle of the needle you would like to see on the floor. So I usually use this one. So I'll go ahead and flush this with ceiling, or maybe not. I just want you to see what happens if I don't flush it. Let me just pull this back. Let's land in. Let's keep it here a little bit. When we were pulling back on the dilated sheet, we landed a little bit far down. So as you can see, there's a warning that says needle inserted without flushing. So this simulator does remind you that you did something wrong. So we have our needle in place. And again, I'll go back to these kind of like a clock. So it says that we're at 3 o'clock with the sheath and the needle is at 3 o'clock. We should kind of rotate all of this together for about 5 o'clock. We'll go back a little bit, and then we should see our jump into the fossa. There it is. Now, what I can do is we can push some contrast through the needle to mark our fossa. It'll look like this. Now the simulator will actually show you the tenting. So if I push my dilator just a little bit over through the fossa, on the fluoro, Now my conscious kind of washed away. You can see the tenting, but you can also see the tenting on the on our ice catheter. And as I rotate this, we can do puncture in different positions. You can see here, and if I rotate it a little bit more, you can see that you can pick the position where you would like to perform your puncture. So the puncture, it's not done right in the center of Vasa all the time. So you can pick, depending on what procedure you're doing after this, where you would like this puncture to be performed. Now, as I insert my needle, you can see that it tends even more, and then we will go puncture through. And now at our needle pressure, you can see that the pressure is actually changing. So it tells us that we are, that we punctured successfully and that we went into the left side of the heart. Now also, I can confirm my puncture. I can look at ice. I can look at my contrast just to see if we went through. Now I was just flashing contrast through the wire. I'll go ahead and just cross over with my sheet. There it is. And at this point, we can remove our the needle. And we can also go ahead and confirm this again with contrast, flushing the contrast through the sheet. So that would be our conceptual puncture. That's all it is for this one. After this, you can go ahead and do different procedures like maybe an LAAO or mapping or whatever else you need to do after this. I'll go ahead and remove this, and I just want to go ahead into the floppy fossa real quick just to kind of show you that there's a difference between these cases. Let me just exit out. Now, when you exit out, there is a procedure report, and it just tells you that what we did, pretty much it's, if you have a user signed in, which you can do, you can create usernames and passwords, you can create curriculums. If you do that, it will show you the username, what procedure you did, case, general info. This is just, you know, time we spend on the procedure, use contrast and how much we did. Then it goes into radiation safety, just the dosage of radiation we expose ourselves and everybody else, and handling events. So if there are, if you did any complications, which you can actually do in our in Transepto, even though this is one of the most cases performed, there's still a lot of complications that could happen, and that's why we could use simulators to kind of try to avoid those complications. And our simulator does show you if you perforate the RA or LA or any other complications that could happen when you do this procedure. It also keeps track on the inventory we selected. So if you need to keep track how much what these clinical devices are you're using, then the simulator will also keep track on that. And this is just a report that talks into details what we did from kind of start to finish. Yep, so we have our floppy FASA, and this one is laid out pretty much the same like our first one. Scenario, patient information. This one is a 35-year-old male, I believe. The first one was a 32-year-old younger person. But I'll go ahead and insert my wire first, and then follow it with the dilator and sheath. And I'll show you the difference in the FASA once we get there. So my wire again. And maybe this time we'll just keep it in the T so that you can see the difference between the ice and the T. If you're not quite sure where the T points to, we do have a little cheat sheet here that it will tell you the angle where the T points. And if we do kind of move it around, that angle will change right there. And this is, let's go to the back. So my wires and things, and this time I will be a little bit more careful not to bend our dilator too much on the sheet. I just saw a question. So somebody asked a question. There was a window that popped up for assembly calibration. Can you explain what that is? Oh yeah. So when you insert the needle, and once we get there in a little bit, I'll show you exactly what this question was all about. So what that means is that our simulator accepts tools that are straight, and they don't have angles, so it doesn't really know where the needle is, if it's you know, at 3 o'clock position or 12 or 6, it doesn't know. So what we do is when we insert our needle, we usually point it at 3 o'clock, and then we just confirm with the simulator that that's a 3 o'clock position, and that we're kind of align it with this arrow here pointing at 3. So this is exactly what this question was about. So we just make sure that we align it properly, and everything is pointing at 3 o'clock, and just calibrate. And what the system does, it kind of just puts everything together in a place where it should be. So 5 o'clock, and first jump, then this, and second one followed right there. Now this is a floppy FASA, and you should kind of see it just in a second here. Let me switch to contrast. So this is a FASA. And as I push this in, you can see there's a lot of tension, a lot. And this is the one that you could actually create some complications if you push too much and hit the left wall, then you can potentially just puncture it through. If you do that, our simulator will warn you that you did it. So you can see it's tending quite a bit. Maybe ice would show it better. Yeah, so you can see the tending. It's really will yeah, it bumps it through. Now, if you're wondering if the simulator has feedback, yes, it does. So you will feel, especially when you do the pasta puncture, you will feel a lot of resistance on your needle. And once you pop it through, you will kind of get that pop feeling that you punctured something. In the second procedure, that's a fibrotic fossa. That one you can feel a lot of feedback on your needle, just because the way the fossa it's structured. So that is it about our conceptual puncture. Now I will go ahead and open it up for questions, if there are any, and I'll just wait for them a little bit and see if they come in. Feel free, if you do have questions, I believe on your GoToMeeting, there's a chat box. You can just submit them there and I should be able to see them. I believe there's a question that somebody was asking if, I guess they have seen our TE trainer, and if we could implement if that's implemented with conceptual function, or if we can combine those two together, meaning the simulator and the trainer. At this point, all of the echo and ice is controlled by this portion conceptual puncture, but down the road we will have actual simulator side by side with this system that we have here, and you can in real time you can manipulate the probe on the other end, or if you use the ice catheter, you can do that. So instead of using these buttons, you will have kind of like an extra small simulator with the actual key probe or ice catheter, where you can manipulate the views. So I hope that answered that question. Okay, I guess there's no more question. I would like to thank you all for joining me this webinar today, and if you would like more information about Mentis, this procedure, you can always go to our website, www.mentis.com, and we have nice documents, videos, all kinds of information about Mentis, and also what we do and what procedure we offer. Thank you again, and we'll see you at our next webinar.